Hey, what's up guys? In this video I'm going to show you how to get input from the user in Android Studio. So let's start. First of all, you can see that in our activity underscore main.xml file, our root level element is relative layout. Now you have to create an edit text, and width would be match parent, height would be 50 dB, and margin top 20 dB, margin right would be 30 dB, and margin left will also be 30 dB, and here will be hint is enter your name. You must have to give an ID to your edit text, like Android colon ID is equal to @ plus ID, and I am giving the ID edit text one, and after this you have to put forward slash at the end. Now you have to create a button. So when you will be click on the button, our Android app will be get input from the edit text, and it will show it on our screen. So width would be wrap content, height would be wrap content, and you have to give an ID like btn1 or button1, and put forward slash at the end. And now you have to give at layout below @ID edit text 1, and Android colon center horizontal is equal to true. This property will center our button. And now you have to give margin top 20 dB, and you have to give Android colon text is equal to get input. You can write any text inside your button. And now finally you have to use an text view to display your entered name in your edit text. So when you will press the get input button, our Android app will be get input from the edit text and display on our text view. So width would be wrap content, height would be wrap content, ID would be text view 1, and you have to put forward slash at the end. And now Android colon center horizontal is equal to true, and layout below, Android colon layout below, you have to give ID of button, which is button 1. And now you have to give margin top is 30 dB, or I think 50 dB will be fine. Now our user interface have been clear. Now you have to go to your Java and com.example. your package name, and inside your package name here you can see this file main activity. So main activity.java, this is the backend of our file. Now you have to first of all initialize your buttons. So the method of initializing button is that you have to type first of all edit text. This is a class, and you have to give a name to this edit text, like I am going to this name this edt1 semicolon. Now we will declare our text view and button as well. So you have to type button btn1 semicolon, and now you have to type text view tv1. We have declared our these three widgets. Now we have to also initialize these edit text button and text view also. So you have to type this edt1 is equal to typecast this edit text, and find view by id r.id.edit text1, put semicolon at the end. Now you have to type here button 1 is equal to typecast this by using button keyword, and find view by id r.id.button1. So this is the ID that we were give in our XML file, button 1. This is the ID that we have been given in our this section. So by using this we can access our data front end views in our Java backend file. And now you have to type here tv1 is equal to text view, find view by id r.id.textview1. Now you have to set a on click listener on your button. So what will happen when user will click on the button in our app? So you have to type the button name, which is btn1 dot set on click listener, set on click listener, and you can see that this one, first one, when you will press enter, it will automatically clear this function and type new, and again when you will type on, so it will show you a suggestion, view dot on click listener. When you will click on this, it will complete its remaining coding automatically. So all the coding we will be do in our this section, from this to this, this coding will be executed when the user will press on the button. Now we will declare a variable inside this like string input is equal to edt1 dot get text dot to string. So this line will be get input from our editText and store this inputs in our this variable, which is of type string. And now we want to just show it simply on our text view. So you have to type here tv1.setText. SetText function is used to set text on our editText, on our text view. So I will set text input. And now our app have been completed. Now let me run the app and see what happened. So guys, you can see that this is our app, and when I will type like cubic soul, and when I will press get input, and this it shows me this input of this edit text on this text view, and like cubic soul software development company, like software development, and when I will click on get input, it will get input from our edit text and it will show this on our text view. So I hope that you will must like this video, and you are seeing that this our app have been run successfully. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can ask us in the comment section. We will try to answer your question. And finally, thanks for watching.